Let's talk about sex, baby.
Yes, we are gonna go there.
What is one of the biggest killers of your sex life?
Infidelity!
Yes! Oh my goodness! Who would have thought that one of the toughest parts of having a baby was getting your partner to have sex with you? So, how do you keep the fertility process fun and not feel like a chore? How do you help your partner not feel the burden of trying to conceive and the disappointment month after month? How do you reconnect with your partner after infertility hits? This is exactly what I'll be talking about in today's video. I'll be providing you with some tips and tools of how you and your partner can stay positive and connected through all of the highs and lows of your fertility journey. Hi, my name's Jennifer Robertson, and I'm a fertility coach and a writer. I'm also a fellow fertility warrior, having struggled for 7 years to conceive my own two beautiful babies. I'll be honest with you, I had no idea that it would be so tough. I had no idea that one of the biggest struggles would have been sex. I had no idea of the impact that it would have on my sex life. To begin with, I had this vision of passionate lovemaking, that we were creating this life, and that didn't happen the first month, and then it became like a chore and all of the romance was sucked out of it. It was really, really tough. Today, I'm going to share with you 10 tips on how you can recreate intimacy in your sex life while you're on your fertility journey. Before we dive in though, please feel free to give this video a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe by hitting the button below and tick the little bell as well so that you're notified every single time a new video comes online. And if you stick around to the end, I am going to share with you how you can get your hands on some extra tips on recreating intimacy in your relationship. Tip number one, I know it's really awkward, but one of the best ways to get around this is communication. I know that it may be awkward at first, but if you can speak to each other in a non-confrontational way, I think you'll be surprised at how both of you are feeling. I certainly wish that I had spoken to my husband at the time so I knew exactly how he was feeling, and so I knew that it wasn't me. Tip number two. Now there are two schools of thought here. You can tell him when your ovulation window is coming up, or you can keep it a secret and just spring it on him each month. Find out which he'd prefer. Would he like to know and have a bit of warning, or would he not want to know so that you can be a little bit more spontaneous? Now, if he doesn't want to know, just make a move without letting him know. Don't mention cycles, fertility, ovulation, anything like that. Just make a move. Tip number three. Now, if he would prefer to know and have a little bit of warning, that's great. But you don't have to be as insubtle as "it's go time," which is what I used to do. Perhaps an idea, and you can create your own, an idea might be just to put a little love heart in lipstick on your mirror of the morning that you know that you're ovulating. And that way throughout the day, he can make his move, or that night, or even the next day, he could make his move, but on his own time frame. That way the ball's in his court, no pun intended, and he can make his move whenever he wants. Tip number four, every time you have sex, make the goal an orgasm, not a baby. That way, you put the effort in just as much as he does. And the bonus is you get to have an orgasm. Tip number five, if you're normally a morning sex couple or a night sex couple, then try not to switch it around. You'll just end up putting extra pressure on yourselves. And if you're trying to do it right there and then, you might be tired and you might not be into it. Try not to put too much pressure on it and just go with whatever you would normally do. Tip number six, contrary to belief, you don't have to be going at it like rabbits. No wonder you're so exhausted. There is a window, 5 days prior to ovulation and then 2 days after, every second day, but you don't have to be doing it so many times that it gets completely overwhelming and that you're both exhausted and it becomes a chore. Tip number 7, please be patient and try not to let him see your frustration over sex. Gentle encouragement with zero judgment is the best way to approach this. Tip number 8, give yourselves a month off trying to conceive so that you can have some time to reconnect in a natural way so that you can approach sex in a more easy way with less pressure. Go away for the weekend and just really reconnect. Take the pressure off sex. Tip number 9, the fun one, mix things up a little bit. Go to a different location. Remember the days when sex was just really fun and spontaneous and snuck around? You know, try a different location. Try the car, the backyard, the beach. You know, shake things up. Add some extra spice into it as well. Foreplay, big one. Toys, big one. Just try to spice it up a little bit and make it a little bit more exciting than just having sex to have a baby. And finally, tip number 10, and the most important thing, this isn't about you. The struggle has got nothing to do with you. It is merely the situation. We all go through this struggle. Now go out there and reclaim the intimacy in your sex life and your relationship. If you would like to know a little bit more about how you can reclaim the intimacy in your relationship, pop on over to one of my other YouTube videos. It's an interview with Dr. Morgan Francis, and we really get into it in a lot of depth as well. You can also subscribe to my blog on my website, which has a whole heap of tips and tricks as well. Just pop on over to www.yourfertilityhaven.com for a whole lot more. Thank you so much for tuning in, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, click the subscribe button below, and tick the little bell as well so that you're notified every single time a new video comes up. So thank you for joining me, and don't forget, you are so much more than your fertility journey.